Hi there, I'm back with part three of our series on Introduction to Trigonometry, and we're working through a bunch of problems just to help you get a feel for how this all fits together with sine, cosine, tangent, and the meanings of those, and all of the other cosecant, secant, cotangent. So the directions here, we've got theta is an acute angle, so that is our reference angle. It gives us what sine and cosine of theta are, 3/5 and 4/5 respectively. And it says use identities to find the tangent, cosecant, secant, and cotangent of theta. Where necessary, rationalize the denominators. Well, we don't have any square roots in this, so we won't have denominators to rationalize at all. So what we need to do is we need to figure out what opposite, hypotenuse, and adjacent are, because those are the three things that we need in order to use sine, cosine, and tangent in relationship to our reference angle. So you'll remember that sine is opposite over hypotenuse. So the opposite is 3, the hypotenuse has to be 5 because they give us the ratio 3/5 for the sine. The cosine is adjacent over hypotenuse, so the adjacent side has to be 4, and again the hypotenuse is 5. Now that we know those three things, we can find the rest of our information. So the tangent TOA is opposite over adjacent, so that is 3 over 4. The cosecant is simply the flip or the reciprocal of the sine, so that is 5 over 3. The secant is the flip of the cosine, so that is 5 over 4. And the cotangent is the flip of the tangent, 4 over 3. So that is all that we need to do in order to find all of our trig functions based on what we were given. Identify opposite, hypotenuse, and adjacent, and then use the identities, what we know sine, cosine, tangent, etc. stand for based on these three values of our triangle. Moving on, asked to find the value of the sine of 77 using a calculator. So doing that, we just simply have to have our calculator up. I'm using the calculator that is in Windows. And we have to make sure that we have degrees here. These other things, radians and grads, those are just different ways of measuring angles that we're not going to cover here in this video. We're concerned with degrees for this, so we need to make sure that you're using degrees on your calculator, whether it's in Windows or whatever calculator you're using. And then you just go 77 and find the sine of that. And we want it to round to 4 decimal places, so 1, 2, 3, 4. That means this 3 has to be rounded up because the 7 is above 5, so 0.9744. So the sine of 77 is approximately 0.9744. And that's all there is to using a calculator to find the value of the sine. Moving on, we're asked to find the value of A here. In this. Now ideally we would be able to use the Pythagorean theorem, but we don't know what c is, so we can't use it. A squared plus b squared equals c squared. We have two unknowns, we can't use Pythagorean theorem. We can, however, use our knowledge of these trig functions, because we've got a reference angle here of 36 degrees. And if we want to find A, this A is opposite of 36 degrees. So we've got arso, ka, toa. So if we're going to use the opposite side, we're forced into either using the sine or the tangent, because those are the two functions that use the opposite. And then the 230 is the adjacent side to our reference angle of 36. So we have to use this tangent of opposite over adjacent. So we can write our equation, the tangent of 36 degrees is equal to the opposite side A over the adjacent side of 230. And then we just have to use our calculator to find the tangent of 36 degrees is 0.7265. So we'll write that, 0.7265 is equal to A over 230, And now we just simply solve this equation for a, multiply both sides by 230. And we get 230 times 0.7265, 167.9095. I'm just going to round that to 167 is approximately equal to A. Depending on what we wanted, we might need things more accurate than to the nearest whole number, but for the purposes of this, I'm just going to round it to the nearest whole. So A is approximately 167. Now, I could use Pythagorean theorem to figure out C, but the disadvantage of that is that I would be using a rounded answer to get another answer, which is going to increase on the error of rounding. So it would be best to find C by using trigonometric functions again. So if I want to find C in relationship to 36 degrees, C is the hypotenuse, so I'm going to have to either use sine or cosine, because those are the two that use the hypotenuse. Again, I don't want to use this 167 because that's rounded, so I want to use this 230. That 230 is the adjacent side to my 36 degrees. So that means I have to use the cosine, because cosine is adjacent over hypotenuse. So the cosine of 36 degrees is equal to the adjacent, 230, over the hypotenuse of C. Again, I've got to go to my calculator and figure out what the cosine of 36 is. So 36 degrees, cosine, 0.8090. I'll round that to four decimal places, 0.809, because the zero is dropped. So 0.809 is equal to 230 over C. Need to solve for C. I'll multiply both sides by C to get rid of my fraction. So 0.809C is equal to 230. Divide each side by 0.809. And we get C is equal to, I'll do this on my calculator again, 230 divided by 0.809. And I get 284.3. And maybe I should write this approximately equal to 284.3, because I've rounded that again. And that kind of fits with what we know about right triangles, that the hypotenuse has to be bigger than both of the legs. The hypotenuse is the longest side. Okay. If we needed to find this angle here, we would just simply use what we know about angles in a triangle. We'd have 180 total for the triangle, so we would have to take 180 minus 90 is 90. 90 minus 36 is going to be 54, so that angle there would have to be 54 degrees. So moving on, again we have to find the measure of the side whose right triangle is, of the right triangle whose length is designated by the lowercase c. So here we've got our reference angle, 37 degrees, and we've got 16 is opposite, and the hypotenuse is C, so opposite over hypotenuse, that is going to be the sine. So sine is opposite over hypotenuse. So we have to say sine of 37 degrees is equal to the opposite, which is 16 over C. And I'm not going to show this work. I would suggest that you pause this video and try to figure this out and make sure that you're able to get the same answer for C. The correct answer for C is going to be 26.6. So that's, again, approximately for that. moving on, we've got the last thing that we're going to be talking about is the inverse functions. So at times you've got the degree that you don't know. You don't know the angle theta. You do know that the tangent of this is 0.8635. So To do this, we want to find what is called the inverse tangent. So we want to find the inverse tangent. On a calculator, it's that key, the tangent to the negative 1 power. It's not really to the negative 1 power, but that's how it looks. We want to find the inverse tangent of this value, 0.8635. And when we put that into our calculator, you'll notice here that for my calculator, I have to use this inverse key first. A lot of calculators you have will just have this tangent negative 1. So I'm going to clear what I have. So I'll go point, whoops, clear again, 0.08635 inverse. And then you'll notice I have all of my inverse tangent functions. So here's my inverse tangent. Hit that, and I get a value of 4.935. Okay, so that means my angle is 4.935 degrees, and I got a tangent of 0.8 on that. So we can check that. So if we have this 4.935 and I just find the tangent of that, I should get 0.08635. And it looks like I might have entered that in incorrectly with a 0.0. So let me try this again and just make sure that I entered in things correctly, which is a real common little mistake. So I don't feel bad about making a mistake in this video. It's something that you have to be careful about when you're working with math, is that you're really taking care of things and making sure that you're covering those details. So 0.8635, and I want to find the inverse tangent. So that looks like a little bit more sense rather than the 4.935. Let me erase that. It'd be better to do this. So I'll erase that and I'll get 40.81 degrees. So that looks a little bit more reasonable for a number of degrees. So 40.81 degrees. Now if I wanted to check it again, I've got the 40.81. I'll just find the tangent of that and I should get back to this 0.8635. Yeah, so I get 0.8635. So to the nearest tenth of a degree is what they wanted it to, so I'll round that again to about 40.8 degrees. So that is really kind of it in a nutshell for these trigonometric functions. Those are the basic things that you can do. Obviously, there's a lot of applications that you can get into using sine, cosine, tangent. You can find any part of your right triangles using those, just given a little bit of information about either the sides and or the angles of your triangle.